Yeah, man, what's up, Purples? I'm in the Blessed Beats. Welcome to the Black Hole and another episode of Investments News. What is going on in the musical gear equipment industries and happening in the world and all of that? Investments, stocks, photos, NASDAQ, Dow Jones, paper clips, Windows 95, Windows 98, etc. What is so incredible about this today is because a guy let me know on Instagram. Sorry, I'm drawing a blank right now. I can't remember your name, but if you watch this video, give us a shout in the comments, you know what I'm saying? The M8. I had no idea that this was in the making, but it is essentially a LSDJ for 2050 or some shit like that. Look, for those who aren't familiar with LSDJ for Game Boy, this might look like gibberish to you, but it is a tracker, and it's a handheld tracker at that. The layout of the software, all the shortcuts, essentially everything is exactly the same as LSDJ. So if you pick this up and you already know how to operate LSDJ, you'll feel like a fish in a fish tank, swimming around in joy. Dissin, you can make patterns on it and chain them together, make complete songs with it. It's got 8 tracks, a whole bunch of different synth engines, sampler. I mean, just look at this beauty right here. It is one sexy motherfucker. The only thing that I doubt a little bit is, are these keyboard keys as nice in a handheld grip as on the Game Boy operating LSDJ? Because this makes a lot of sense when you're operating something like this, but holding it in a handheld grip like this, I don't know about that. We'll see about it. It's gonna cost you $450 to pre-order this, which is little bit pricey, but also, I mean, look at the quality of this rugged build right here. Not to mention all the development that's gone into it with a very small team. It's made by a musician called Trash 80. His real name is Timothy Lamb, and they have been exposing a little bit of footage of this thing in action on some live streams. So this here is what the interface looks like, and I love this look, man. It's a lot of numbers. It looks like it's a lot of numbers and stuff to a lot of people, I bet. But I mean, the aesthetics of this, I really like this digital, old school, lo-fi tech feel compared to something like the Polyend Tracker, which it's not very inspiring to look at. The whole graphical interface is very uninspiring. I want to feel like, I want that nostalgia feeling from something like this. And as you can see, if you know LSDJ, this is the instrument edit screen, and you can look at that down here at this little tree branch of different modes: the song mode, the chain mode, I can't remember what the poop mode, instrument, and table. You got samples, multiple synthesizer engines, and 8 tracks, and maybe first and foremost, So many modulation and routing capabilities with this. The sound design possibilities are damn near endless.
So that's that feature. Look through the list some more here. So
this is song mode right here. This is where you chain patterns together.
Option for sending as well. This is especially handy.
It's got a lot of MIDI functionality as well. Like, let's see what else we have on the screen here.
This octave, so you can help
stream.
And that's totally in a little bit after I show
effects commands that you can set step by step or in the table attached to an instrument.
Some of these fault you be useful.
Before we move on, there are so many people who watch my channel who do not subscribe. So please, I'm trying to take this to the next level. Smash the subscribe button and ring the notification bubble down there. All right, let's go. There's a lot to look at here. I suggest you go check out the streams for yourself and the website. I'll link to the channel in the description right about around here. Matter of fact, you can do any type of music that you want to with this. Of course, it doesn't only lend itself well to chiptune music, but it does do it hella well. So let's listen to a demo from Disposable Planets from New Jersey, who made a demo track. Yeah, we just gotta get to the hook. Wow, that is beautiful. That is beautiful. What do you think about this? Are you looking to get one of these? I had no idea it was existing. Now, Mr. Trash 80, Mr. Dirty Wave. I do a little trade here, something like that. I cannot afford this right now, but I would love to have it. I can't justify the gas for it. But if you got the money and you love LSDJ, you're going to love this. What do you think about it? Me, honestly, I think this might be a runner-up for the best portable music-making device that there is. And I'm not counting OP1 and them into that, because it needs to be the Game Boy grip. That's what I want. And this looks like a very potential machine when it comes to that. I'm very excited about it. Also, I know portable gear, even though I barely ever use it, it's such a nice idea. It's kind of like playing around with a dollhouse, I guess. I don't know. Join us in the Discord, The Black Hole. Don't miss the weekly Beat Challenge on Tuesdays. Big one love to my astronauts, my patrons. What else? Ring the notification and that thing. Okay, bye-bye.